ABC News with John Greaves. Landslides triggered by heavy rain have destroyed hundreds of houses and a school in the central Philippines, with fears up to 200 people could have died. The governor of the Reserve Bank said he expects interest rates to rise rather than fall. Sue Lannan reports.
On a gloomy October day in 1982, the wooden ribs of a Tudor warship broke the surface of the Solent on the south coast of England.
And here she is. She's just broken the surface. And there goes gun salutes. And what an amazing sight.
The raising of the Mary Rose was a national event, the culmination of an extraordinary feat of engineering.
His Royal Highness Prince Charles has just left the Todmoor for a short time in order to board the Mary Rose. And all the ships sounding their horns in salute to the Mary Rose, resurfacing after 437 years.
If you think I look nervous, you're dead right. I'm glad I'm not the first. Oh, God, I really feel sick now. No, I'm not praying. It's what you do to protect your ripcords in the plane. Now, I just hope I can remember everything. The sky beckons once more, but for now, I'll give it back to the birds.
The worst part is being knocked on your back. You just have to lie there like a beached whale until someone picks you up. John Greaves, SBS Sport. Yeah.
But 9 MSN users tell us that they had trouble accessing this one.
Around 2 PM Monday on the 9 MSN News homepage, under Latest News section, was a headline to the effect of "Former host Liebman criticises Today program." I clicked on the link, which took me to the page, which simply stated, "The article you have requested does not exist."
Your Royal Highness, your ancestor, King Henry VIII, is reputed to be the father of the Royal Navy as we know it today, and in fact named the Mary Rose after his sister Mary Tudor. However, in other historical terms, is the Mary Rose a part of our great naval heritage, or is its value one more of a national heritage?
Well, I think the Mary Rose is important because it is part of a naval heritage in the sense that it was one of the important forerunners of the Royal Navy.
Developing a syringe range that can be disarmed and disposed of at point of use. So, what's so special about these syringes?
Camels first set foot in Australia in 1860. They were brought in for the ill-fated Burke and Wills expedition. From then till 1920, about 15,000 camels were introduced to the continent, with many used on the construction of the famous Gann Railway from Port Augusta in South Australia to Alice Springs.
It's true.
What's true?
The lovely blouse is on sale now at Baldy Lingerie in Monaco.
True?
True. It's a brand name from Germany.
The name's International Video. James International Video. In fact, it's Mr. James.
Nice boat, mate.
Yeah, he certainly is.
Do it a bit of sprucing up, though.
Yep.
Welcome to World Watch PM. I'm John Greaves. Tonight, the Chief Constable of South Yorkshire is suspended over the Hillsborough inquest. More hardship for the people of Venezuela. And the corrupt practices to feed the appetite for ivory in Asia. Those stories and more in World Watch PM.
Good enough.